Once again, I apologize for using the term enlightened, but for a person to have really had not even just the words, like spiritual, enlightening, you know, mystical, divine experience, those words are just words. For someone to actually have gone to those places that where you become one with the universe and the galaxy and you understand it all, like, they would have to have been able to sit silently for at least 2 to 3 hours. If you can't sit by yourself silently for 2 to 3 hours, then and you never have, maybe with the guide of some music or something to keep your slight attention on so you don't fall asleep. But if you're not able to do that, if you're not able to keep your conscious attention on something for an hour or two, or maybe three, I would say three, then there's no possible way of somebody who has been awakened or enlightened or anything like that. Because once it happens, say once an experience that measures up to that caliber would happen, you need to clear your mind and get over some of the major stuff that just hits you when you realize that you're really not the person or the thing you thought you were your whole life. When that hits you, you really need time to do it. Some people may conceptualize it a little bit and be like, oh, I get it. But they didn't experience it. And they say they have because they get it. Getting something and experiencing something are two separate things. I want to help people not only get it, understand it. I want them to experience what we are. So they can see. Like, once you understand completely, it's almost like being, like, your body is a spaceship that you get in every time you, like, you decide to do something, your spirit decides, all right, I'm taking this spaceship and I'm flying here. Like, the grass can't move, but we can. We have legs, but our spirit is in this body. So in a way, we are in a spaceship flying, but we're just in a robotic, organic suit. I don't want to say robotic because I don't want robots to be involved in this. But if you think about the fact that most people these days who have become, quote, unquote, enlightened, have been trying to make a bunch of money. Because they say that, you know, you need money to get out of the rat race and all stuff. And yeah, you do. But there's a point to it where I'm going to say that, yes, I want to do that. But at the same time, with the aim of getting rid of money altogether. For the world to operate as a whole. That's my true goal. I'm not trying to be enlightened and, you know, they say to accept things and just let things go and whatever. Yes, people do need to learn, and all the Aborigines and all the whatever and all the people that can't communicate right now aren't going to immediately learn. But we learn slowly but surely as a whole from somewhere. And I'm just suggesting it comes from right here, like from me, showing you where what we're doing, experiencing what we've been, not just knowing, not just understanding, and not just conceptualizing, but experiencing it, experiencing true God. And I don't want to say true God because that makes people, like, because I'm not trying to say, because if you're religious, you're going to think when I say true God, you're thinking of a being. I mean, if you're not religious and you think if I'm saying true God, you're thinking of some magical dude in the sky that I think makes things work, but that's not it at all. There's no visual representation of it, except for everything you see, and everything you don't see, and everything in between of every possible aspect. And from galaxy to every historical event and every future event, they're all there. And it's easy to understand once you totally get it, but I gotta go, because it's starting to rain, and I want to go inside, because I'm not wearing a shirt. Peace.